Well, our favourite red-headed prince is celebrating his birthday and Meghan has shown her support for Harry. Let's get all the latest royal news from our correspondent in London, Gavin Grey. Top of the morning to you, Gavin.
Top of the morning to you guys.
Hey, what's Meghan done for Harry?
Well, so Harry turns 35 and we think they've spent the day quietly together with little Archie. But turning to Instagram, Meghan Markle has sent a really, really nice message along with a sort of collage of different photos of different periods of Prince Harry's life from baby up to adulthood. And on Instagram, she wrote this for her husband, wishing a very happy birthday to His Royal Highness Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex. And it continues, a birthday message from the Duchess of Sussex with your service to the causes you care so deeply for inspires me every day. You're the best husband and most amazing dad to our son. We love you. Happiest birthday, and a little heart emoji as well. And as I said, a little collage of pictures there. It was quickly followed on the Instagram account by the Queen, also wishing a happy birthday, by Prince Charles wishing a happy birthday. And then we were all desperate to see, is the split with Prince William and Prince Harry going to mean there were no wishes from there? But no, there were wishes from William and Kate too.
Look, that's all lovely and fruity and flowery and gorgeous, but Meghan's estranged nephew has topped that by honouring his cousin in a rather unusual way.
Yes, that's right, Ange. So this is Meghan Markle's half-brother's son, a chap called Tyler Dooley. He lives in Oregon in the States, and he's a marijuana farmer. Oh. He's got 100 acres or so over there, and already he's released a batch of his product called the Markle Sparkle. Now, he says it went down so well that he's now released the Archie Sparky. And the Archie Sparky is obviously to commemorate the birth of little Archie on May the 6th. And he says, you know, people think we're all hillbillies over here from a dysfunctional family, but I actually worked jolly hard on this. Now, I don't know whether he sent any over to Buckingham Palace for them to have a little try at this, but one thing's for sure, it has not received royal approval.
It's like a Louisiana cookout. I don't know, Archie Sparky, it's a little bit derivative and it doesn't rhyme. So, you know what? I expect my drug dealers to do better. And it looks like the royal couple are adding new additions to their home. Craig.
Yes, we talked about this a few weeks ago, where they had done work over and above what the planners had agreed in the garden of Frogmore Cottage near Windsor. And so, consequently, the couple have now actually received retrospective planning permission. In other words, they had to say, can we have it? We've already started it. And the councillor said, yes, it's an outdoor kitchen area and seating area and a handmade barbecue costing roughly 7,000 Aussie dollars. And they also have permission for what's been called a privacy hedge. You'll remember that a public footpath runs very near Frogmore Cottage, so they're obviously desperate to try and get a little bit of privacy there as well. A lot of the planning application was redacted, however, meaning that the likes of me couldn't actually quite work out more of the precise detail that we wanted to know.
Nice. Also, I've got some breaking news for you, Gavin. It also turns out Harry and Meghan have just got the new contract to build the next high-rise residential development block in Mascot in Sydney. So that's going to go well as well.
They'd love it.
Now to another member of the royal family. All is not looking rosy for Harry's uncle, Prince Andrew, as now a Hollywood star has claimed that he came knocking on her door looking for sex.
This is extraordinary, Jan. Yes, so Prince Andrew at the moment, of course, has been to answer lots of questions about his friendship with the disgraced financier, the late Jeffrey Epstein. And on top of this, it is now being said by Courtney Love that Prince Andrew turned up at her Hollywood home uninvited at 1 a.m. with a protection squad officer, and she claims he was, quote, looking for sex, as you say. Now, she said that didn't happen. He stayed for 45 minutes and then he left. What I absolutely love about this story is that she says she made him a cup of tea. And guess what the picture was on the pot with which she made the tea? Yes, it was the Queen. So out of the pot that Mummy had there, apparently he had a cup of tea. Now, as I said, she says he left without any sex taking place. And indeed, at the time, it wasn't disputed that he had visited her, but he has always, of course, denied any wrongdoing.
All right, very quickly, I need to talk about my favourite royal, and that is Big Phil, Prince Philip. apparently, his final memorial has been decided already. I mean, still got a lot of life in him yet, hasn't he, Gavin?
You are 98, so a couple of years before the big 100. But what he's actually doing is that there's all sorts of talk about, you know, how to best remember him in the future when he's no longer with us. And it is being rumoured that the so-called fourth plinth in Trafalgar Square, which, believe it or not, was set aside for King William IV 150 years ago, but was never actually put a statue on there. Well, it is being looked at as something that could possibly be some sort of a memorial to Prince Philip. Now, in the last few years, having remained empty, we've had all sorts of things. There's a winged bull on there at the moment. I think that's it. But in the past, it's always been a huge thumb. There was a massive blue cockerel on there. And what I loved is another artist said, let people go up there and actually do what they want for 2 minutes. And in typical British style, somebody immediately went up and stripped naked. I don't think Prince Philip would be too amused.
Can I just say, if Fleet Street hasn't already dubbed that Plinth Philip, someone should be fired.
Oh, that's a great headline.
Oh, very good.
Gavin Grey, always great to chat. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks, Gav.
Cheers, guys.